This week's top eight, interesting one. I call it our Mason Storm top eight. For those of you not in the know, Mason Storm, that's Steven Seagal's character in Hard to Kill. Top eight creatures that just won't die. By the way, that is Steven Seagal's best film. Hard to Kill, Kelly LeBrock, man, I was in love with her. She's also the female lead in Weird Science, but yeah, Hard to Kill. All right, tons of honorable mentions here. Do you want to lead us off? You had an honorable mention, Frankie?
What was that? I totally forgot what it was.
I think yours was Carnage Tyrant.
Oh yeah, Carnage Tyrant's definitely an honorable mention. This is, it's a newer guy, so he hasn't had time to really shine as much as the other creatures on this list. So, I just think it's great. It's been showing a lot in Standard. And traditionally, cards like this or Gaia's Revenge have seen play. So, or in, like, older formats. And, I think this card's good. So,
all right, kids. Uncle Mashi is going to take you on a little road trip of honorable mentions here. It's story time. So here's what happens on your old Magic TV top eights here. Everybody talks about all the new cards, and normally it's your old Uncle Mashi and your old Uncle TBS who fight for the old school stuff. But nobody listens to Mashi, and everybody listens to TBS. This week, there was no TBS. So I'm going to throw out some honorable mentions for some older stuff. Trust me, these creatures were hard to kill. Or they didn't stay dead. They just, you might have gotten rid of them, and once you did, they could still come back. Honorable mention number one, Nether Spirit.
Also a Steven Seagal movie, just worth noting.
Which one?
Hard to Kill.
Hard to Kill was the original. That was in the open.
What?
Frank is not paying attention. Frank is not paying attention at all. All right. Nether Spirit. I mean, there was a time when you played like blue-black control. You can even play blue-white control and not have any black mana and still have Nether Spirit as your recurring, recurring way to like come back, right? Nether Spirit, if there are no creatures in your graveyard, it comes back into play. So you killed it. The next turn, guess what? It came back. It just kept coming back. And it was a blocker. It was there all the time. Nether Spirit, not hard to kill, but hard to keep dead. My personal favorite, I've had this argument so many times with the team here at MTV, Frenetic Ifrit. Trust me, there was a time...
Yeah, this card was obnoxious.
The card was amazing.
Well, gonna flip a coin.
Yeah. Frenetic Ifrit, one blue, one red, one other for a 2/1 flyer, right? For zero mana, you could flip a coin and it would either phase out or it would be destroyed. And trust me, I mean, you just block, flip, block, flip, block, flip. Oh, it died? Okay, it was going to die anyway. Block, flip. Oh, it damage used to stack when our good friend Mr. Frenetic Ifrit was in type 2. So you'd be 2 damage on the stack, flip it, phase it out. There you go. Boom, take 2. It was amazing. It was such a pain.
Did you guys not get I was referencing your Steven Seagal reference?
What?
I wasn't like saying that independently of what you said. I was calling back.
Do you like how Frankie's still catching up here?
Well, no, because like I'm just reading the chat. Like people are apparently like apparently you guys thought I didn't hear you, and that was the sole reason for me making the comment.
Frank, when you have to explain the joke, I just gotta tell you, man. When you have to explain the joke.
I mean, some people like yourself are not quick enough.
Guys,
I think. So it's
leave Frank out of this. I don't want him to feel like he's under siege. See what I did there? You see what I did there?
Well, at least I'm not on deadly ground here.
Yeah. Come on. Let's. You got to pay. You got to pay for when you don't pay attention, Frankie. You're not above the law. All right. So let's bring it down here. I know the chat's out for justice on this,
but
we all understand where we're at with the hard to kill stuff. Okay. We're all
wow.
The same
this
page.
Really.
All right. Two more
quickly.
Two more. Very, very quick. Maybe not honorable mentions. One, Frenetic Ifrit was, as I said, at one time, I think the best card, the best creature in Magic. This other card, also at one time, indisputably the best creature Magic, Morphling. Morphling was very, very hard to kill. You would see this thing get accelerated out on like turn 3 off of the Grim Monolith with one blue mana up to keep it, untargetable. So Morphling, trust me, there were so many times that a Morphling would hit the board and you're just like, oh my gosh, I can't get rid of it. It can pump up its defense, it can become untargetable. Morphling was so insane. There was a reason we called Morphling Superman. And it wasn't just the fact that he could block anything, he could kill you, he was also untargetable and for all intents and purposes indestructible. Not keyword indestructible, but indestructible. And then finally, Blastoderm.
In the world, are we still on your honorable mentions?
These are all my honorable mentions because none of them made the list. Finally, Blastoderm. Blastoderm's insane, and I get now overshadowed. But in the World of Fires, when it was at five, it was a 5/5 haster. With fading, of course, it only lasted 3 turns, but if it had haste with fires, it could do all 20 to you. And it was a 5/5 that you couldn't target with spells or abilities. So impossible to get rid of. Couldn't block to kill it. All you had was speed bump after speed bump. Elf, bird, try to stop it. Doesn't have trample. So that was the Blastoderm. Okay. Honorable mentions over. Let's start with the actual list. Coming in at number 8, an actual old school card. A great, great card. Rainbow Ifrit. Of course, Rainbow Ifrit, primary kill condition in good old Randy Buehler's mono blue control deck. I think you only played like 2 of these, I think. But man, she was very, very hard to get rid of. 1 blue, 3 other for a 3/1 flyer. 2 blue, phase her out.
This deck just didn't lose.
This deck was the worst to play against. It was
miserable,
freaking awful. It had like 2 Rainbow Ifrits, 4 Stalking Stones, and that's like the win condition right there, right? That was it.
Yeah, that's all you needed.
Yeah,
like you would never be able to kill the Rainbow Ifrit ever.
Nope. And damage stacked. Remember, 3 damage, phase it out. 3 damage, phase it out. You have a lightning bolt, good luck, phase it out. I mean, and the best is when they had Nevermisk, right? So you go phase out my Ifrit, pop the disc, kill everything you have. Oh, look at that, my Ifrit's back, and it's a 3/1 flyer that's going to eat you alive. So love the Rainbow Ifrit. Great art. Love the art on Rainbow Ifrit too, but extremely difficult to deal with. All right, coming in at number 7, there were so many of these, we just dropped them in as a category. The gods, maybe the new gods we should call them. You have Keranos, Hazoreth, the Scarab God. These guys, they're either indestructible, so you can't get rid of them that way, or they just come back once you kill them.
Yeah, what they just return to your hand.
Yeah, I mean, I could not believe how good Hazoreth was when I played with Hazoreth this weekend. And, I mean, the Scarab God is just unbelievable. I mean, did any of you watch the Pro Tour coverage? The Scarab God's just like an unstoppable force. Like,
yeah, that card is definitely worth being, it's like definitely worthy of a $50 standard card if there ever was one. So
yeah, insane. And the gods, I mean, and that's the flavor of it, right? They're either indestructible or you try to get rid of them and they keep coming back, because guess what? They're gods. And I guess that's what gods do. That's, there you go. That's what gods do. All right, number 6. You're very familiar with this card if you've played in any Grand Prix this year. Ye old
2017. Or if you've watched any of our top 8s before.
It's made a few top 8s, but every one of you who played in the main event, you got one of these. Coming to number 6, Progenitus. I mean, what are you going to do? You're starting on a Progenitus. Just ask yourself, what are you going to do? I mean, you got like a Diabolic Edict? I don't know, a Chainer's Edict? I mean, what are you going to do? It's a Progenitus.
Yeah, it's a hard dude to deal with.
It's when the Progenitus hit, it's game over quickly.
That's the plural.
Well, you know, maybe
are they legendary? Is this legendary? Progenitus legendary? It's got to be legendary. Yeah. Right?
It's legendary. So
I don't think you can ever have a Progenitus.
You do if you have a rules lawyer in play. You get a rules lawyer, double Progenitus, GGGM. That's what I thought. All right, number 5. Number 5 on our list, not hard to kill, but hard to keep dead, Bloodghast. There is seriously nothing more annoying than dealing with a Bloodghast. Every land!
It's funny because Bloodghast is not an annoying card by itself. It's just a 2/1, it can't even block. So if my opponent plays a Bloodghast on turn 2, I'm just like, all right, cool, attack you for a bunch. The problem is that it's later in the game. That's when the problem persists. When you're like, oh, you got 3 Bloodghasts in your graveyard. You play the land. Oh, good, it's a fetch land. So even if I deal with these guys, they come back.
Oh, it's...
it's real annoying.
Yeah.
It adds up.
And again, it's one of those things where you can kill the Bloodghast, but you cannot keep that ghast dead because it's going to keep coming back and it's going to get you. All right. Those are our bottom 4 on this week's top 8 creatures that are hard to kill but that just won't die. I still like hard to kill. You know, I'm going to stick with that one.
Stick with hard to kill.
Take a moment.
I like the Steven Seagal puns.
There you go. If you're watching this on ChannelFireball.com, leave your top 4 guesses in the comments. No peeking. You got to hit pause and give us the genuine, real deal guesses. If you're watching us on YouTube or on Twitch, let us know in the chat. What are the top 4 hard to kill creatures? Let's see what we got here. Anything good? Okay. I see what's happening here. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I actually thought number six was a different card. So that was my reference to if you've watched Magic TV before.
No, that is coming up. I think that card has moved up the list. So let's see here.
Invisible Stalker in the chat.
Blinking Spirit.
Go pet that dog, jeez.
Poor Hunter. Poor Hunter.
Oh, he's doing just fine.
There's one on there that's Someone's brought one up that we had it in the chat. It didn't make the cut, but I'm starting to think now. Maybe
Police Main Line was terrifying back in the day. Like, oh god, you have 5 mana. I'm never going to be able to deal with this.
That's true. Ooh, Mongoose. That's oh man, love it.
There's just too many magic cards.
There are so many good ones. Oh yeah, there's a card that. This list got changed quite a bit, I think, because there's another card that I think we left off that maybe should have stayed on there. But all right, we got enough guesses here. Oh, Mo Runes. Okay, I see it. Coming in at number 4. She is impossible to deal with, and the real tragedy here is if you don't deal with her, you will lose the game in short order. Number 4, Emrakul.
That's who I was referring to.
Huh?
That's who I was referring to.
That was number six. It was at number 6 at a certain point, but I mean, Emrakul is so impossible to deal with, and the minute she hits, all you want to do is try to find it out because she's going to eat you alive.
And it's funny because even if you prevent the damage somehow every single turn, like, you just don't get to play the game anymore because of Annihilate.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter. She doesn't have to give you damage. She's just going to take the board over. You need an answer.
Yeah, she's just going to reset, send you back to the Stone Age in terms of board state.
Yeah, you need an answer. You need an answer now. Coming in at number 3.
Emrakul is indeed a she as well. Someone asked in the chat.
Yeah, oh no, she's definitely a she. She's a she. Coming in at number 3, many of you have guessed this, and it actually supplanted one of my honorable mentions. Coming in at number 3, Aetherling. How many different versions of Lings have been? There's Morphling, there's Torchling.
Lings.
Lings, yeah.
Then there's, how many Lings we got here?
Aetherling. There's a few Lings out there. Is there a green one? Is there a Greenling? I think there's a green
Thornling.
Thornling? Thornling. Yeah,
Thornling is the Greenling. There's also the Redling, which was like Torchling.
Yeah, Torchling. Torchling's terrible. The best Lings are Bluelings, Morphling, and Aetherlings.
Bluelings.
Yeah. Here we go with Aetherling. Aetherling's a beating. I mean, a beating, right? You know, it's just like a Morphling, only bigger and more deadly. So, and so impossible. For one blue mana, you can rescue the Aetherling out of anything. So, so hard to deal with. Once that Aetherling sticks, GG. Like, what are you going to do?
Someone mentioned Library of Ling. Yeah. Oh, my God.
It is what it is. It is what it
Chat
is.
Chat OP.
All right, coming in at number 2. Very, very happy with this at number 2. I am a big fan of the fish. I'm a big fan of the Merfolk, and I am a big fan of the tree name Nemesis. I remember when I read this card, I was like, wait, what? Wait.
Hold on. Because you have to read protection from a player multiple times to really grasp what it does, because this is the first time that's ever been done.
It's true. If you pick up this card and try to rip it, if you're the named player, it's unrippable. You can't do it. It's not allowed, guys. It doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
True name Nemesis. I mean, protection from a player. Like, what is going on there, right? Another.
That ability is still pretty unprecedented.
It's interesting. Yeah. Wow. We're gonna have to have a discussion after we get to number 1 here about some cards that I think were on original versions of this list and didn't make it through the last minute changes. But yeah. True name Nemesis, when it hits, particularly in the right matchup, you're out of answers. There's not much you can do, and you're just going to sit there and get whittled away 3 points at a time. All right, number 1 on our list of hard-to-kill creatures that just won't die. Has anyone guessed this? Have you guys been watching? Has anyone guessed what number 1 is?
I don't think so. I have not seen it.
It's funny. Whenever we have that number 1 that nobody's guessed, I think a few people go, oh, I see what you did there. But most people are like, what the heck? And I'm being kind there. Coming in at number 1, Slippery Boggle. How many friggin' matches have been decided by that Slippery Boggle you just couldn't get rid of?
That and it's such a frustrating card.
So frustrating.
This is a card where once you see it on turn one in Modern, you're like, I see.
Yes.
Here we go.
It really is that moment because you go, now. We're going to do this, are we?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, I see how it is. Now I understand.
I see what's happening here. I see what you've done there, and I do know what you are going to do. So let's race. And that's what the boggle is, right? Because you are racing.
Yeah.
The removal, unless they run that boggle into one of your creatures, which isn't going to happen, you're racing. And the boggle, I mean, it's so funny. It's a one mana 1/1. You know, all it takes is a pebble in the shoe to make life unbearable. And that slippery boggle is that pebble that you cannot shake out of your
shoe.
I think
the flavor text should just say, whelp.
Yeah, whelp. Here we go. All right, there you have it. Those are our top eight creatures that won't die. Top eight creatures that are hard to kill. I do have to say, there maybe should have been room for Troll Aesthetic / Thrun on the list. I know there were early versions of
that's
of
every week though. There's so many magic cards, you know.
I'm a fan of. I mean, how many times have we strapped up a sword to a Troll Aesthetic and been like, "All right, I got this."
Back in the day, a lot, yeah.
Yeah. And yes, you know, Ghost Dad's. Tough to get rid of. I agree with that. So,
agreed.
All right, there is our top eight creatures that are hard to kill. The Mason Storm list. That does it for our top eight for the week, and that does it for our Magic TV for the week. Thank you so much for watching. Do want to remind you, now at the very end, so you can hit stop and not listen to this, all of our Magic TV top eights brought to you by ChannelFireball.com. All of the cards we've discussed on this week's top eight available on ChannelFireball.com right now. I wish all the movies we discussed were available on ChannelFireball.com, but unfortunately that's not the case. Maybe you can find them on streaming. I don't know.
Wait for the ChannelFireball.com add-on on Netflix that's coming soon. Oh, so yeah. Keep your eyes peeled for that plug-in.
Loot box. All right, Frankie, are you on next week?
Should be.
I unfortunately will be absent next week. I'm flying out to Lyon for the GP, so I will not be here.
Me and Andy?
I think it's going to be you and Andy because, yeah, I think TBS is still going to be in Australia. So the far superior Channel Fireball editor-in-chief, Andy Cooperfaust, will be in the hot seat next week. And he will be joining you along with Armando Benavides, Big Worm, our Magic TV intern, Frank Lepore, at Frank Lepore, Hunter Lepore, at Hunter Lepore. Actually, I don't know if that's true or not. I just thought I'd say that. Darksteel Humphrey, of course, will be here. Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left, I will be absent, but everyone else, we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching.